Philippine Senator Jinggoy Estrada ruled out the possibility of passing a law that would grant a 150 peso wage hike to minimum wage earners by Labor Day. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri is seeking a wage hike for workers amid soaring inflation. Estrada says while he agrees that a wage hike is necessary, the proposal needs to undergo a thorough public consultation first. The senator also emphasized that consultations on wage hikes should not only involve workers, but also their employers.
It's been only a year since the full reopening of the country's economy following the two-year extensive COVID-19 restriction. But despite the projected strong economic rebound, we're still struggling trying to return to the pre-pandemic levels. Alam mo, more than the issue of wage increase is the matter of job security.
Philippine education spokesperson Michael Poa says the review of the country's K-12 curriculum is in its final stages. The initial review of kindergarten to grade 10 was completed in September 2022 and has since undergone consultations with education experts and stakeholders. Meanwhile, the assessment for grades 11 to 12 began in November last year. Poa said the goal of the review is to decongest the K-12 curriculum as a long-term solution to addressing learning loss. Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte vowed in her January education report the agency would be making the K-12 curriculum more responsive to the needs of 21st century learners. Philippine government troops vow to intensify operations against private armed groups. Acting Defense Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. expressed hope this move will help pave the way for peace in communities. He made that pronouncement during a peace process meeting for the Bangsamoro region in Cotabato Province. The former government peace advisor also vowed to ensure security in the historically restive region. The issue on private armed groups again came to the fore after the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo. President Marcos had ordered a crackdown after the incident.
The Philippine Justice Secretary reiterates his call for Congressman Teves to return home. Remulla said the government has not failed to assure Teves he will be provided with enough security. He added the congressman's refusal to return home is an indication of guilt.
Ayaw umuwi yata ni Congressman Teves because fearing for his safety. But there are no excuses for us. These are poor excuses not to face the charges.
A key equipment to contain the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro is set to arrive on Monday from Japan. The Philippine Coast Guard is eager to use the remotely operated underwater vehicle, or ROV, that can reach the sunken tanker, assess the damage, and even plug the oil leak. But until this is done, the Environment Department had estimated that the oil tanker could be leaking up to 50,000 liters of oil a day. Senator Sherwin Gatalian says he will recommend to the government to acquire the country's very own ROV.
Natuklasan namin na kulang sa kagamitan ang ating Coast Guard. No? Kaya umabot pa na halos 3 linggo bago makahiram. So yun naman ang aming maitutulong sa Coast Guard at of course sa ating mga national agencies na bigyan ng gamit para makaresponde kaagad. Bibili tayo, no? ROV, itong mga boom, itong mga ship na mga barko na pwedeng gamitin.